Hey everyone, in this video, I wanted to show you how to make an effective thumbnail on YouTube. Now, I actually paid for a consulting to improve my thumbnails. I actually previously made a video on how to make thumbnails, and I thought they were effective, but when I changed my thumbnails on this new channel, it really started increasing my views. So in this video, I wanted to show you these new effective thumbnails, and I wanted to show you how you could make one just like it. So I'm gonna use Photoshop to create these. So let's start from scratch. We go to File, New, and we want to create a new document. And 1920 by 1080 is perfect. That's the size we want. And we want to label it. And I'm gonna press Create. Again, black background's fine for this. And now that we have this black background, we want to start with putting a background image here. So depending on your video, it could be a screen grab from your video. My videos are animation, so sometimes I use animation background. In this case, I downloaded this picture. This is what I'm gonna use as my background. Go ahead and open the image with your background, and you could just drag that and drop it into the new Photoshop file. So that's how I'm gonna put it in here. Again, if it doesn't fit, press Command T and you could resize it. In this case, it actually fits perfectly. So I'm gonna press the check mark and not resize it. If you Google free stock images, you could actually download these for free. A lot of images just like this one. Now that I have that, I want to create a border around this one to really make it pop. So I could double click this and do stroke. And with the stroke, I want a large size stroke. So let's go 35 in this case. And I want it to be on the inside, that's fine. I want to change the color to something that will really grab your attention. So for money, let's go green. That's nice, and press okay, press okay. Again, the bottom I can't see, so if I resized it, I would be able to see it. So I'm gonna go ahead and resize it so it all fits the screen, and press okay. If for some reason this border effect is not working out for you, another way is if I create a new layer, you could just grab the rectangle tool, and again, you could press and change the color to anything you want. And you could just draw that rectangle anywhere you want. So if you want, you could create it just like this on a new layer. So I'll just show you how to do that just like that. So now if I turn the other one off, you could see how I created a border a different way. So I'm just gonna turn that one off and I'm gonna delete these, but that's another way to create that border. Next, we wanna create our texts. So let's create a new layer. Everything should be on a different layer so you could change them independently. So let's press T and put that right over here. I usually use this font Roboto. So if you don't have it in Photoshop, go ahead and Google it and download it. And black is good, 400 is good. And obviously with the color, I really like neon. That's the new one I'm going with. This light blue is nice, red is nice, yellow is nice. But in this case, again, I'll go with the color of money. And this font size actually might be too big. So let me change that to 200, press okay. And I'll just type in my title. So I'm gonna add to this title later, but just for the sake of this, let's go with this, press okay. And if I press V, I could move it somewhere over here. And I could double click this actually and change it so it's on three lines, just like that. And I'm gonna press check mark here. Next, I want to really make this pop. So I could double click this and add a layer style. So on this layer, I'm gonna double click here. Now where the text is just next to the text. And I want to do a stroke. I'm gonna select stroke and I wanna change the stroke to be black to make it really pop. Press okay, and the stroke size, I need to reduce it to about 13, and I'll do outside stroke. So it should look something like this. Press okay. Again, if I press V, I could move it to where I think it should fit. And I could always double click and change the font size. So if I want it to be even bigger, let's do 250, I could do that. And if I click this here, this icon, it gives me the spacing between each line, so I could change the spacing so they're not touching. I'm gonna press okay. All right, so we're almost getting there. Next, we want to put the book here or an image. So if you have an image, if it's you talking, this is a good place to put it. In this case, it's a book review, so I have it on a different file right here. I'm gonna go ahead and select that. I'm gonna bring it on to my Photoshop file and drop it here. I'm gonna press Command T to resize just to make it bigger. I'm holding Shift so it doesn't change the aspect ratio. If I don't, I could reshape it any way I want to, but I want to keep the aspect ratio. And I'm gonna press OK, press V again to place it somewhere over here. And that's my top layer. I'm just gonna label this book so I don't forget what it is. Okay, so now the one thing that we need to change is this background image is a little bit distracting. It's hard to read the text. The text will look better with a darker background. So I'm gonna come back to this layer. I'm gonna change the text of this to label it what it is. And now I'm gonna double click the FX again, and I want to put a satin overlay. So I'm gonna check that on, and you see the difference here? Mine's at a 50% opacity at normal. At zero and at 50, even at 75, it might be even better. Yes, so it's not really distracting anymore and the text really pops. Let's look at before and after. Look at that. Really makes the text pop. So I'm gonna press OK. This is it if it was on black. This is it with that background layer. So again, with the amount of text you wanna put here, I wouldn't go more than 5 or 6 words. But in this case, I might change this text because it's saying exactly what the book title is saying here. So I'll put something like this for the title. I'll change it. Again, it's going underneath the book. So I'll select everything. That's Command A here on the Mac. And I'm gonna change the font size again to be 200 so everything fits. And over here, if I select this, I could make everything in all caps. Since I didn't type it in all cap, I could just press that, make it all cap, press check mark. If I press V, I could place it somewhere over here. Again, it's not fitting, so either I could decrease the size of the book or I could decrease the size of the text. In this case, let me go ahead to try to make the text 180. That fits, but the spacing is too significant between them, so I'm just gonna go ahead and decrease that spacing to something like that. Press OK. And again, it looks like I need one more space bar. There we go. Now it's even. Press OK. Now you could play around with a couple other things, like changing the text color so it's not all green. So you could change the word freedom, for example, up here, select this, and maybe I'll do that light blue I like. Press OK. That still looks great against a darker background. I'm gonna press OK up here. So that's how you go about creating a thumbnail that's really effective and highly clickable. These colors are gonna make it stand out. This border is gonna make it stand out. You could even throw your branding somewhere here. Like if you have a logo, that's good to put that here. But I just went through my channel and changed all my thumbnails to look like this. So I wanted to share that with you so I could help you grow your channel with these more attractive thumbnails. I hope this video was helpful. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for a lot more tutorials just like this one. And I hope to see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.